Residents who are currently being housed in the various schools in Mepe and its adjoining community are still battling with a lot of issues that need to be urgently addressed by the relevant authorities as they keep hope alive. At the St. Kizito School and the Roman Catholic School, where one can only go by crossing the flood water, women were seen cooking for their families while the men went about transporting items to their safe havens. Some of them have been speaking with Joy News.
Mi jo le mi a fo mo ba le bi efe nu e mi a du kwa ha zo agba nu o fi o fo le mi e si. Mi a mo kaka mi a ba bi mi le mi e ga o cho ha o shi e shi e ma. A va ge le mi e du. E ko sto yo mi wo fe fe le jajra ha. O ha ma shen light melo ta e la o fe te o gbala.
Here I am hosting almost 20 household, and in each household, people in one household is averagely, I can say, 6 in each household. So when you want to take a creditor, meaning about 5 to 6 households are in one room. Those who are sleeping outside are not part of it. So today we pray to God. The army came for one intervention that they were putting up the tents so that some of the people can be sleeping in. The people are greatly affected. Food to eat, water to drink, because the water has been polluted. All the toilet facilities were taken under the water. So you could see the refuse dams were all taken. So the people cannot get water to drink. Even if you bring 1,000 bags of sachet water, it will get finished. No water, so no food. We want them to help. And we are not asking of already cooked food. That you bring the food item, the people will cook it. But providing food in, how do we call it, takeaway, and asking 2 people to take 1, it's an eyesore. But if they provide the food, the people, rice, oil, the people can cook it themselves.
Now we decided to visit other schools where the affected residents are putting up with their families in the night just to assess the real situation on the ground. And what we saw was really terrible and very sad. Let's hear from them.
Since the emergence of the flood, houses have been submerged. So, you know, accommodation for people have become so difficult that I have to leave my shop for police to also relax, since they have no place to sleep. So for the past 3 days, they have been sleeping here, and work too is now hot. Work is still more coming because of the submerged houses. ECG thought it wise to off the light for safety reasons. So we're asking that government should come to our aid so that they can put things in place for us to get back to our old time.
And with their latrine submerged, sanitary conditions are fast getting worse, and the fear of outbreaks is palpable. Stella Kumaju is the Volta Regional Environmental Health Officer.
Environmental Health Officer, Volta Region, we came to assess the situation in North Town District, precisely Mepe Town. We came to where they said is the safe haven. And so I asked to look at their toilets. if you see what I saw, very terrible. Even the path leading to the toilet is overgrown with weeds, and it will not encourage anybody to pass through. To all well-meaning Ghanaians, our development partners, to come to the aid of people in the affected districts. We can arrange for mobile toilets for them. We can also arrange for Digni Loo or any type of toilet that is safe, convenient. Because if we don't do this, I fear that in the very near future, we'll be recording outbreak of diarrheal diseases, which also will be another disaster.